Hi folks, right, this video we're going to try and make a little house in 3DS Max and tune it up. So you can get those materials if you watch the last video off my website, the Toon materials from Super Mario, and mess around with them and make yourself a little Toon house. So this one we're also going to make the house and then apply the bend modifier to it so it looks all messed up. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create it in two elements to start with. First of all, create a box. Let's go into one window. About that kind of size. And then center that. So go on to your transform tool and right click on the origins here, so we're all in the center of the world. Now the shape I want it to be is I want it to be tall and thin, so I'm going to go stretch it a bit like so, and then I'm going to reset where it lives in the window. I'm going to right click on that viewport and go save current view as home. Next thing is go convert to an editable poly. Yep, convert to an editable poly polygon, select when that decides to work. In fact, we'll go into selection mode, not transform tool. We want to go now extrude, and I should have selected the top one. Stop that for a second. Go extrude. In fact, no, sorry. Inset to start with. Pull in the walls a bit. And then go, yeah, tick that. Extrude. Extrude list, I should say. Now we're going to quickly jump into wireframe mode so we can see where it goes. So you can see it more clearly like that. Drag it all the way down to approximately the point where the floor is, i.e. roughly the same size as the walls. Tick that. We're staying in wireframe mode for the moment. Now we're going to select that poly on the face and go inset. Draw it right in to about there. Tick that. Now we're going to go into vertex mode. Select the two vertices there. Pull them inwards. And then on the opposite side two. Then two there. Pull them in. And now we're going to go polygon. And drag that down. As long as it's not overlapping the floor, want it roughly approximately in line with the floor, so there is only a tiny, in fact we could, no, we'll go like that, so there's a tiny little step. Let's just have a look at that side on. Up a fraction more. Yeah, that should do us. It's got a little doorway. Now we're going to move that doorway off to the left. Or right, I should say. Depending on what angle you're looking at it from. Or you're thinking of it from, I suppose. I'm thinking of it from behind, so that would have been left. Next thing is, we're going to go extrude. This time we only want to pull that in so it's just halfway in between the wall there, like so. So pull that right back approximately just over halfway and then go tick, then select the back polygon. No, not that one, nor that one. Go in the top window, go inset, and now we basically want to line this one up with that other one. as best as we can. So we can leave it like that. We'll make it a little bit thinner. That doesn't really matter actually, because we can alter it by vertex mode. So go into vertex, select ignore back facing. Sorry, not that one. These two here. No, those two there. Pull that over. Then select all them four, but not that one there. Go hold down Alt to unselect one. Oh, Control Z to step backwards. Right, now we want to unselect them two. Pull those over. Then select them two again. Can't see where I am now. Oh, there. Sorry, I was holding down the wrong key there. I was meant to be holding down Control. But I was holding down... oh, whatever that is. Pull that over so it lines up approximate. Yeah, not too bad. Might be able to scale this up, actually. Yep. Then go back into move mode, pull it down. So it's in line with that other door. The front door, that is. Pull that up to there. Right, now go back into the top view. So we're looking down onto it. Polygon. See, so we've got a polygon now that's in line with the other one. Now from the side view, we're going to go extrude, turn off back faces. So that will just push it in. It's a little out of line there, that's okay, but it's overlapping this one here where my cursor is. Perfect. And then just go delete. It's got an open doorway now in the building. And we'll just double check that to make sure it's so. Yep. Now there's a little doorway. Well, it's not quite there yet. In polygon mode, select that one and go delete. And there's our doorway. So the next thing to do, come out of poly, turn off edit poly, go into modify. Now before we do that, I think we'll add the roof so we can bend the whole thing as a single unit. So go back into home, pull that to one side for the moment, go create box. We want this approximately the same, a little bit bigger than that one. So we're going to do it this way this time. There we go. Now scale it upwards. On the top face, before we convert it to an editable poly, I want to break that up into, I think it's length segments. Go into edged face mode so we can see what we're doing. So I want two on the top and then two on the width. So I've got a point in the very center of it, basically. And now pull it up again. Scale it so it's approximately the same size, but just slightly overlapping the house. And now pull it upwards again. So it's the same height as the house. Roughly, it's not important. Now pull it off to one side. Convert to an editable poly. Go into vertex mode. Select that top vertices there and pull it upwards. One moment. We have a problem. Yep, for some reason. Actually, no, that's all right. Pull it up again. Just double check that the whole thing is the same. No, I'll tell you what's happened there. Go undo move, undo move. I don't know why it didn't pull it up accurately from the center, but we're going to try that again quickly. It's pulling up those edges there, but it's having trouble with these two outer edges here and here. Now that could be for one of two reasons. Undo move, undo, ah, there we go. It could be the fact that it's not a perfect square, which it doesn't look like. Try that now. Vertex again. No, it's still not working. So what we're going to have to do is go undo move, select all the verts on the top. Now, one minute. I'll tell you what, select edge, select that one, and that one, pull it up now, that's what we want, right, okay, yeah, that'll do, that's the roof, and come out of edge mode, now shrink this down again, shrink it down even more, go back into edge mode, transform, pull the roof right up. Okay, that should do us. Right, now we want to line these both up to the center of the world by right clicking there. So they're both in a line with each other. Drop that one down, but we're not going to attach them just yet. In fact, it's still a bit too big, that roof, so bring it down a bit more. Yeah. Now we're going to change our view once again. Set current view as home. Next thing to do is that with that top, with the roof selected, go back into edge mode and select that one, and transform, pull it out there, then that one and that one, pull that out there. Go back, undo move, undo select, something's gone wrong there, undo select, undo move. Now try that again. I think I had the wrong one selected there. So let's pull them out, see what happens again. Yeah, that's it. There's our little house. Now for the to toonify it up completely, we are going to go select the bottom one, making sure we've got no gaps there. No, that'll do us. Going to go attach and then select the roof, so it's a single unit now, but in element mode. Okay, now we're going to go modify, bend, wherever that is, there. Now we just go angle, like so, direction, pull it forward. See how there's our little bent up toony house. And then we're going to collapse that, so right click on, whoops, get it into our... Actually, I think I'm going to come back a bit on that. I think I'm going to have the roof going backwards. That's better. And then we're going to go right click, go collapse to yes. So that is now part of the object. There we are, there's our skew with mental looking little cartoon house. So next thing is go change its name to Toon underscore house underscore 01. Save that name, go copy, and then save as. Pardon me, before we do any more, put this in my UDK folder, or one of my UDK folders, but this time under a new folder called cartoon underscore assets, and then open that up and then paste in the name there, Toonhouse 01, and go save. So we are now going to go unwrap UVW, edit, expand UV, check face, then go mapping, flatten mapping, check this box, by material IDs, and there we are. Our house is torn up into its respective material IDs. We didn't have to do this, but I prefer to do that. So we're going to now find out what walls are what by face mode to start with. That's the an inside wall. Pull that out. That one probably is as well. Can't see what I'm doing here. That's now that's the roof. So pull the roof up there. Edit undo move, because I moved its pivot and I didn't really want to do that. Now one that looks like that, that's almost identical, is this one here. No, it's not quite. All we're really doing is now setting the UVs up. So that, now that could be the one that's very strange. So can't see where that's from. It's obvious, I know, it would be the wall that's invisible to us, the wall inside the doorway here. So we are going to now pull that, because it's an internal one, pull that over there. Select that one. That is the base of the roof there, so that can go with roof. Basement. Base floor, so that is a miscellaneous one, we'll stick up there. This one is probably the doorway, right? Okay, now that's these ones here, one minute. Unselect that. Check these internal ones here, these are the doorway. See that? It's all selected there. So we can pull them out. Stick them with the internal surface. Oh, sorry. Control Z to get that selection back. And what have I done there? Drag them over to internal walls. This looks like a roof one. Is it internal? It could be inside. Oh, right, okay, so that's roof. I think that one is as well, isn't it? Yeah. Just double check, because we want to keep everything together. So I noticed that there was an external wall. Pull that to that side. That one is. That one is roof, so is that. This one is the inside the